very warm welcome to St David's and Airmyn for this, our benefit service for what is Low Sunday, the Sunday after Christmas. It's actually only 2 days after Christmas this year, so I decided that it would just be easier for everybody if we had a pre-recorded service and nobody had to be in church and organising things and able to just have a good bit of a rest, because people have worked incredibly hard and I think it's time for a bit of a rest. I'm certainly looking forward to that myself. Next week we will be back in church at 9:30 at Rawcliffe and 11 at Hook and at 4 p.m. in Airmyn. And those services will be streamed and also recorded, so you can watch them at home if you would prefer to do that. Hopefully this service will just flow through straightforwardly and we'll all be able to join in the words that appear up on the service. So let's start with the opening. If you could join in the bits in bold where it says "or," sometimes the bits in bold don't say "or" in this presentation. We meet to celebrate the coming of Christ into the world. The Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory. Raising our eyes to heaven, we pray. Almighty God, your Son has opened for us a new and living way into your presence. Give us new hearts and constant wills to worship you in spirit and in truth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our first carol is "As with Gladness."
Thank you.
that we can use over this Christmas period, members of the Church of England, so we're very grateful to them. We come now to our prayers of penitence. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, the first commandment is this: Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is the only Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this: Love your neighbour as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Christ, the light of the world, has come to dispel the darkness of our hearts. In his light, let us examine ourselves and confess our sins. Together we pray. God of mercy, we acknowledge that we are all sinners. We turn from the wrong that we have thought and said and done, and are mindful of all that we have failed to do. For the sake of Jesus, who died for us, forgive us for all that is past, and help us to live each day in the light of Christ our Lord. Amen. May the God of love and power forgive you and free you from your sins, heal and strengthen you by his Spirit, and raise you to new life in Christ our Lord. Eternal Almighty God, who wonderfully created us in your own image, and yet more wonderfully restored us through your Son Jesus Christ, grant that as we come to share, as he came to share in our humanity, so we may share the life of his divinity. Amen. parents took him to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. The law of the Lord says, if a woman's first child is a boy, he must be dedicated to the Lord. So they offered the sacrifice required in the law of the Lord, either a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons. At that time there was a man in Jerusalem named Simeon. He was righteous and devout, and was eagerly waiting for the Messiah to come and rescue Israel. The Holy Spirit was upon him, and it revealed to him that he would not die until he had seen the Lord's Messiah. That day the Spirit led him to the temple. So when Mary and Joseph came to present the baby, Jesus, to the Lord as the Lord were required, Simeon was there. He took the child in his arms and praised God, saying, Sovereign Lord, now let your servant die in peace, as you have promised. I have seen your salvation, which you have prepared for all people. He is a light to reveal God to the nations, and he is the glory of your people Israel. Jesus' parents were amazed at what was being said about him. Then Simeon blessed them, and he said to Mary, the baby's mother, This child is destined to cause many in Israel to fall and many others to rise. He's been sent as a sign from God, but many will oppose him. As a result, the deepest thoughts of many hearts will be revealed, and a sword will pierce your very soul. Anna, a prophet, was also there in the temple. She was the daughter of Phanuel from the tribe of Asher, and she was very old. Her husband died when they had been married only 7 years. Then she lived as a widow to the age of 84. She never left the temple, but stayed there day and night, worshipping God with fasting and prayer. She came along just as Simeon was talking with Mary and Joseph, and she began praising God. She talked about the child to everyone who had been waiting expectantly for God to rescue Jerusalem. When Jesus' parents had fulfilled all the requirements of the law of the Lord, they returned home to Nazareth in Galilee. There the child grew up healthy and strong. He was filled with wisdom, and God's favour was on him. This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. So we have this story of Simeon, who, realizing that this child is the hope of Israel, knows that he can now rest. Sometimes just small shoots, tiny things, can be the sign that something is going to happen. And I think there are small shoots that are happening around about our churches and around about our communities, of God's love and his values coming alive. And some of us need to allow those shoots to grow and flourish. Not to expect that we have to continue to do everything, but to be allowed to rest. We may need, like Anna, to be those who take more of a back seat and pray. But we pray because we have hope. And she comes there and she's able to see that this tiny baby is the saviour of Israel. And she tells other people he is, and that small thing becomes something much greater a long time after she's no longer able to be there. Yet she's happy. So as we face a new year, not knowing what is ahead of us, not knowing where we're going to be at the end of it, having been through a year that has been very different from many of the recent past, we are to be those who look for those little shoots of hope and find in them the power of God. And the power of God working through all sorts of small and different ways in different people. And we are to allow that to flourish and grow, to point to it and to encourage. ourselves a little bit of a rest. Because God is able to do so much more than we can ever imagine or hope or think. Remember that each day of this new year, and allow Him to be the power that changes your world. Carefully, prayerfully, rejoicingly. Amen. Let us declare our faith in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. In today's intercessions, when I say, Lord of glory, please respond, hear our prayer. Lord of glory, hear our prayer.
Thank you.
King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest. May the peace of the Lord be always with you. We have the carol, What Child Is This?
Thank you.
How wonderful the work of your hands, O Lord. As a mother tenderly gathers her children, you embrace a people as your own. When they turned away and rebelled, your love remained steadfast. From them you raised up Jesus, our Saviour, born of Mary, to be the living bread in whom all our hungers are satisfied. He offered his life for sinners, and with a love stronger than death, he opened wide his arms on the cross. On the night before he died, he came to supper with his friends, and taking bread, he gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." At the end of supper, taking the cup of wine, he gave you thanks and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. So, Father, we plead with confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. We remember his dying and rising in glory, and we rejoice that he intercedes for us at your right hand. Pour out your Holy Spirit as we bring before you these gifts of your creation. May they be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. As we eat and drink these holy things in your presence, form us in the likeness of Christ and build us into a living temple to your glory. Remember, Lord, your church in every land. Reveal her unity. Guard her faith and preserve her in peace. Bring us at the last with all the saints to the vision of that eternal splendor for which you have created us through Jesus Christ our Lord, by him, with him and in him, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honour and glory and power be yours for ever and ever. Amen. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread.
Amen.
Draw near with faith. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood, which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Meekly we pray. We do not presume to come to this your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much to gather up the crumbs under your table, but you are the same Lord, whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. So we have a piece of music as we receive communion. You may want to take bread and wine for yourselves, whether it's consecrated or not, or you may just want to ask God to come and touch and meet you by his Spirit. And we have a song, Awake, Arise, Good Christian. Thank you. Father, whose blessed Son shared at Nazareth the life of an earthly home. Help your church to live as one family, united in love and obedience. And bring us all at last to our home in heaven. Amen. To our Lord and King we pray. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer your souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out to the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. Our final carol is A Little Town.
Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit, be with you this day and forevermore. Amen. Go into the world, to walk in God's light, to rejoice in God's love, and to reflect God's glory in his strength.